Well, that's what you mean to say, Shruti? Okay, that's nice. Yeah, please. No, I'll finish with Manish and then I'll come back to you, ma'am. Because that's the third round. You spoke about freedom. Freedom to do what?
Madam, there is freedom in doing everything, madam.
Yes.
But knowing what to do and what is the limits that are applicable. In if we choose a option or a decision now, what are the consequences that are going to be occur? And we must be ready for the consequences.
Yeah.
That's our responsibility and this is our freedom.
Yeah. Now how do you demarcate the limits? Limits will be subjective. Like for example, for me freedom is running around in this playground. And for some, it may not be that. So how, it's so subjective.
Ma'am, the major contribution of a country is in education, ma'am. Right to education is being restricted to the women.
Yeah.
Yes, ma'am. In the primary stages, due to the financial or other cases, the women are being restricted for the value of education. They are not promoting, they don't get a parental support from the education. This is going to affect the future of the country.
Okay.
Yeah, although the women are efficient to work, they are not giving an opportunity. This is the effect of being.
Okay. I just wanted to, you know, just point out, it's not just this thing. You said that, what you call, they are not being encouraged to study. Now, what about the children who are also studying? How do you support them?
Yeah, ma'am.
With regards to rights and duties.
There are many leaders who are roaming in the roads. Even though many students are given opportunities, there are still some students who are, we can see them on the roads, ma'am. The child,
please,
in the child labor, they are working in the industries at small ages. Even though they got efficient and even though they are quick learners, they are being in back roads. So this has to be changed, ma'am.
Okay, that you mean to say that they are irresponsible, that their behavior is irresponsible. Now I would like to know, who is responsible for that, for the correction?
This is due to the parental guidance, improper parental guidance. And orphans, the people who are orphans, they have, government has to take control over them and they, the government has to put them under control.
Government is such a vast statement you have made. Is it possible for the government to control irresponsible people? There are rules and regulations that have been set and we have to follow them. Is it not so? Yes. Yes, ma'am.
Of course, there are many associations, ma'am. There are many associations that has been formed. A proper functioning of these associations will lead to control over these orphans and the children who are irresponsible.
Yeah. Every community has rules and restrictions. And if those rules and restrictions and etc. are followed in a righteous manner, naturally that leads to smooth running and wellness and progress. Is it not so? That's the way in which you want to put it across.
Yes,
ma'am. Okay.
Instead of looking at the world leaders on the ground, we must lead the change, ma'am.
I feel instead of looking at the world leaders and the government, we must lead the change. We must bring the change.
I think she deserves a clap. She says, we must bring the change. We must make the change. Not the government, not the other people. It's we. It starts from us. Is it not so? That is the most important thing. As students, it is your duty to become responsible and to also correct the people who aren't responsible around you. It's we. It's I who start. Normally, we always say put it at the back. So, it's we. Is it not so? I would like here to quote Abraham Lincoln's quote on freedom. It is that it is not the right to do what you want, but what you ought. So there's a lot of difference between want and ought. So it's not, freedom is just not a right to do what you want, but what you ought. Yes.
Ma'am, I would like to support Divya's answer with an example.
Hmm.
If I am crossing a road, I found a stone over there.
Mm.
I was hit and hurt there. I just went. It's not my responsibility. If you are responsible, the solution would be that you should think of consequence that some other is also going to be hurt.
Yeah.
Instead, you should take the stone out from there and put it aside. That is what responsibility is.
But
responsibility is not that someone is going to teach you. It's that what you should do that.
That's what I, just now I said, it has to come from within you. Within you. How far can that be inculcated is my question. How far can that be inculcated in you is my question.
Yes, ma'am. I have an answer for it. Mm-hmm. Stressing on rights and everything, even before concentrating on constitutional rights, one should be aware of humanitarian rights.
Yeah, human rights.
Humanitarian rights.
Yeah.
When you are aware of humanitarian rights, you should think that you should not harm anyone else when you are doing particular job. You should not hurt yourself. It should not hurt your family. When we will be feeling about our responsibility, we will be caring with our parents. We will be thinking of parents. When you think society as your own family, then you are not in a situation that you are going to hurt anyone else. I advise everyone that treat your society as your family. If you treat the society as your family, you are not going to harm them.
Yeah.
That's what responsibility lies there.
Don't you think that treating the society as one family is a real arduous task nowadays, with so much of distinctions on so many other aspects?
It is difficult, but balancing such economic relations and everything is important. One should have a balance of relations in the society. One should respect others.
No, we can't hear you.
When we educate our heart along with our mind, then we feel that responsibility, ma'am.
How are you going to educate your heart? I can educate my mind. How are you going to educate your heart? Just now you said that I should educate my heart as well as my mind for wellness. Is it not so? Now, what is it that you are going to do? Because if you are going to do that, then it means that everybody else can do. Is it not so?
We have many Vedas like Mahabharata, Ramayana and all, man. These days, we are not going through them. If we read them and get educated, nearly, suddenly our heart will be educated along with our mind, I feel so.
Yeah, that's a nice aspect you said. All philosophical as well as holy books teach you. Now, in what way is it going to say that right, you have educated your heart as well as your mind, is it not so? In what way is that going to help you in your duty, responsibility and freedom? Connected to 3 points, duty, responsibility and freedom.
Madam, when we utilize our rights and freedom with responsibility, definitely we can contribute something on our part to the society. I'll take myself as an example. I have the right to be educated and I am utilizing it. And I would like to utilize my knowledge, which I have earned in the process of education, to contribute something on my part to the society. And I have the right to expression and I am utilizing it. And I feel proud to express that I utilized my right to expression for 12 times in our college assembly and I proved myself as a good public speaker. And I have right to opportunity and I participated in various literary events and bagged many prizes in them. And I try to put my efforts to the maximum extent possible and I earn many prizes in them. That is, when we put our maximum efforts, then definitely responsibility, we feel responsible and we realize the importance of responsibility. That is what I feel, ma'am.
I just want a simple listening answer from you. Do you mean to say only an educated person has the right as well as freedom and responsibility? Because every day you have all been telling educated, educated and being educated, and that's why it is like that. I just want to know. I also do not know the answer, that's why I'm asking you.
Certainly no, ma'am. But in schools and colleges, we get educated in classrooms. And some may get education from the experiences, they can learn their experience and get educated in the external world also, in the society also. So I feel we can get education from out of the borders of colleges and schools also. Definitely no, ma'am.
Ma'am, I would like to say something.
Yeah.
Actually, nature is our first teacher.
I didn't get you, child.
Nature is our first teacher, ma'am. We start learning from the nature. No one is going to help us at we are in the womb of a mother. So it's nature that always teaches. So one must be rich, he must learn from his consequences around him.
From the environment, you mean?
Yeah. Absolutely.
Okay.
From the environment, one has to learn the things.
Learn. Okay, that's a nice one, because it's not just that educated people only understand their rights and duties, others also. There are different ways in which, for example, let us say a farmer, you mean to say that he can't understand his rights and duties? He can, is it not so? And his responsibilities also, and he dispenses it also in a wonderful manner. Now, I think it's okay. I would like to now ask Divya, Shruti. Now, you just told me, a very warm welcome to you, sir. In what else way can you use the rights that you have been granted, apart from misusing them? Apart from, you spoke that the rights should not be misused. In what other way can you dispense your rights? Not other way, in a different manner? Yeah.
We have many other rights, ma'am, like we have right to express, right to speech, right to opinion, all these things. The thing is, we should use it in a proper way, ma'am. If we are taking right of expression, so we need to express our, we have the freedom to express our own ideas.
Yes, that's correct, that's nice. Then what else?
The right of respect is, we have the right to get respect from the staff or somebody else, regardless of their age, disabilities and other classifications. So when we come to right of opinion, we have the particular right that we can tell our own opinions about anything.
And how does responsibility enter there? You said that when I express my opinion, I can express it. I want to know how that responsibility enter while you are expressing your opinion.
And when we are expressing our own views, it's our responsibility that we need to speak in a proper way. Like, you should not use any abusive words or any disrespectful words while we are speaking.
Yeah, that's nice. And not trespass others' feelings also.
Yes.
Is it not so?
Yes.
That's a very nice attitude. And Manish, about freedom. Yeah, you as a student now. Now, what sort of a freedom do you think you are entitled to?
There is no such person, as I already said, that there is no such person who is going to give you freedom. It's your own intention. You just take a freedom. But before making your decisions with freedom, you must have a responsibility. We must consider responsibilities. Up to what mark we use this freedom? What are the consequences that this freedom brings us? By considering that responsibility, we can use our freedom.
Yeah. Freedom has a right. That's what you mean to say.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Freedom, does it have constraints?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
It has limits, sir.
It has limits. Now, who imposes those limits on you?
It's been the way I grow, the responsibilities I learn from my life are going to have impact on that man.
Very good. Now, it is really wonderful the way you answered also, children. And I really pray that you understand your duties, freedoms and responsibilities.